Good morning, students. Today, we will continue with the chapter 1 of civics, the Union Parliament. Today's topic is Rajya Sabha. We will discuss the following points. So, the objectives of today's topic are composition, election and term, election of the members, qualification of the members, disqualification of membership, chairman of the Rajya Sabha, advantages of the Rajya Sabha. Let's discuss some keywords. Number 1, denying. It means refuse. Number 2, empower. It means sanction. Number 3, unsound. It means defective. Number 4, nominated. It means present. Now, open your books. Topic, the Rajya Sabha. Composition. The upper house of the Parliament of India is popularly known as the Rajya Sabha. The representation means presentation of Indian states in the Rajya Sabha differs from the state to state on the basis of their respective populations. The maximum strength of the Rajya Sabha can be 250 members, while 238 of them are elected by the states of Union, 12 members are nominated. Nominated means present by the president from amongst men of repute in various spheres of life, example, science, art, literature, and social service, etc. Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha is also called the upper house or council of states, as it represents the state at the central level. The maximum strength of the Rajya Sabha can be 250 members, while 238 of them are elected by the states, 12 members are nominated by the president from various spheres like science, art, literature, etc. However, the effective strength of the Rajya Sabha at present is 245, out of which 233 members are elected and 12 members are nominated by the president. At present, its strength is 245. 233 members are elected from the states and union territories and 12 members nominated by president, like Rupa Ganguly, Ranjan Gogoi, Mary Kom, etc. Election and term. The representatives of each state in the Council of States or Rajya Sabha are elected by the elected members of the Legislative Assembly of the state in accordance with the system of proportional. Proportional means in proportion. Representation by means of a single transferable vote for a period of 6 years. Rajya Sabha MPs, Member of Parliament, are elected by the Electoral College of the elected members of the State Assembly with a system of proportional representation by a single transferable vote for a period of 6 years. Who is MP of your area? At present, Shwet Malik is MP of Rajya Sabha, who represents Punjab, whereas Gurjeet Singh Ojla, MP of Lok Sabha, who represent Amritsar. Election of the members. The Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. It cannot be dissolved like the Lok Sabha. Each member of the Rajya Sabha is elected for a period of 6 years. 1/3 of the total members of the house retire after every 2 years. Members can be re-elected if they so desire and if their electors want it. Every member of a Rajya Sabha has a term of 6 years. In every 2 years, their tenure of 1/3 of its members ends, a new member takes their place. These members are elected by the members of state legislative assemblies. Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. Its members can be re-elected. Qualification of the members. To be a member of the Rajya Sabha, a candidate must possess the following qualification. He must be a citizen of India. He should be at least 30 years of age. He should not be a proclaimed offender. He should not hold any office of profit under the government. Like the member of the Lok Sabha, he or she should possess such other qualifications as may be specified by the parliament from time to time. The criteria to be a member of the Rajya Sabha are the same as that of the Lok Sabha. The only difference is the minimum age, which is 30 years in case of the Rajya Sabha. Disqualification of membership. All the disqualification referred to above in case of the members of the Lok Sabha also apply to the members of the Rajya Sabha. For example, he should not hold any office of profit under any central state government. He should not be of unsound mind, means defective mind. He should not be an undischarged insolvent. Insolvent means bankrupt. He has not ceased to be a citizen of India. He should not have been disqualified by any law passed by the Indian Parliament. The criteria of the disqualification of members of the Rajya Sabha are also same as that of the Lok Sabha. If a person holds any office of profit, if person is of unsound mind, if he is not a citizen of India, or if he is disqualified by or under any law made by a parliament. Presiding officer, chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Like the Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha also has a chairman and a deputy chairman. The vice president of India is the ex officio. Ex officio means authoritative. Chairman of the Rajya Sabha. He acts as the presiding officer of the Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha elects its members, elects its deputy chairman from amongst its members. The duties of the chairman of the Rajya Sabha are the same as those of the speaker of the Lok Sabha. The deputy chairman acts as the chairman of the house when the latter is not present in the house. The Vice President of India. At present, Venkaiah Naidu is the ex-officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. He or she is elected by the member of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. His or her duties are similar to those of the speaker of the Lok Sabha. In his or her absence, the deputy chairman presides over the meetings. The deputy chairman is chosen by the members of the Rajya Sabha. Advantages of the Rajya Sabha. There is no denying, denying means refuse, the fact that the Lok Sabha is more powerful than the Rajya Sabha. But the Rajya Sabha has some advantages of its own. Many great scientists, artists, literary persons, scholars, etc. who feel shy of contesting the election can be accommodated in the Rajya Sabha. They can be nominated to the Rajya Sabha by the president. We all know that the Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha, but Rajya Sabha has its own advantages. It gives representation to independent, talented persons. The states can be given representation in the Rajya Sabha. The representatives of each state in the Rajya Sabha or the Council of the States are elected by the elected members of the different legislative assemblies. The Rajya Sabha represents states at the central level. The Council of States are elected by the elected members of the different legislative assemblies. The Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. In case of emergency, if even the Lok Sabha is dissolved, it is Rajya Sabha which shoulders all the responsibilities of the Union Legislature. It plays a major role when Lok Sabha is dissolved because Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. The Rajya Sabha can declare any of the subjects in the state list to be a subject of the national interest and thereby empower means authorize the Union Parliament to legislate on the subject. The Constitution of India has provided for a division of powers between the central and state governments. Under the 7th schedule, there are three lists: the unions, the state and concurrent. The union list has a range of subjects under which the parliament may make laws. This includes defense, foreign affairs, railways, banking, etc. The state list. The stateless subject under which the legislature of a state may make laws, public order, police, public health and sanitation, hospitals and dispensaries are some of the subjects that come under the state. The concurrent list. The concurrent list includes subjects that give powers to both the center and state government, subjects like education, population control and family planning, criminal law, protection of wildlife, etc. If the Rajya Sabha passes any of the subject of the state list but with two-third majority of the present and eligible voters of the house declaring the subject to have national importance on that subject, Parliament acquires the power to legislate, that is, to make laws. The Rajya Sabha can also decide by two-third majority to set up a new All India service. The Act subject to a two-third majority in the Rajya Sabha also provide for the creation of three more All India services, namely the Indian Service of Engineers, the Indian Forest Service and the Indian Medical and Health Services. Now here we will also discuss the difference between the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the eligible voters, whereas in Rajya Sabha, its members are elected by the elected members of the state legislative assembly. In Lok Sabha, the period of the Lok Sabha is 5 years. In Rajya Sabha, it is a permanent body. 1/3 of its members retire every 2 years. The maximum strength in Lok Sabha is 552 members. And in Rajya Sabha, it has not more than 250 members. Money bill can only be introduced in the Lok Sabha. It grants the money for running the administration of the country. In Rajya Sabha, it does not exercise much power over money bills. More powerful, Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha, and Rajya Sabha is less powerful. Thank you.